Hello, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we are going to discuss about package deployment with parameters. In our last video we have discussed about the package deployment without parameter. So today we are going to discuss about the package deployment with parameters. So go to on SSDT. So I am going to use the same project which we have discussed in our last video. Here we are going to concentrate on deployment with parameter. So here, as we can see, we have a execute SQL task. So let me double click on this execute SQL task, and here I just want to insert record on this account table. And in this account table we have only two columns, first is ID and second is name. And then go to on parameters, and here I have created two project level parameter because we are going to deploy the package. First is ID and second is name. So we want to insert record from this project level parameter to our table. So this is our package. And so let me deploy this package. Simply right click on this package deployment, click on deploy, then click on next. So here, as we can see, a project with the same name already exists. Click on next to replace our existing during the deployment. So it will replace our existing with the new one. So I'm happy with it. Click on next, then click on deploy. So project has been deployed successfully. Now we can close it. Go to on SSMS. Let me refresh this packages, and inside this we should have deploy with parameters. So right click on this, click on execute. Once we gonna execute, then we can see we are having ID and name. So these two parameters were passed in our package. Here we can replace the value. So I just want to replace value by 101. And what would be the name? We can also select name as Shiv. Now click on OK. Now we can click on OK. So once our package will be executed, then this record should be inserted in our table. Now I just want to see the report. Click on yes. So here, as we can see, status succeed. It means our package executed successfully. So here we can check the duration, so how long it was take. Now we can close the report, and we can refresh this table by clicking Ctrl and R. So this is 101 and save. So this is how we can deploy our package with the parameter, and how we can execute our package with using parameter. Next is environments. So here we can create the multiple environments, like we can create any environment for test, and we can create any environment for development. So right click on this and create a new environment. Once we gonna create a new environment, then we need to specify the environment name. So we can specify test environment. Now I am happy with it. Click on OK. So our environment is created. Now right click on this and go to on the properties. So what is the benefit by using environments? So here we can specify the permission, what permission we want to provide for that environment. Like for testing, we don't want to provide permission for manage, so we can remove that one. So our test environment is created successfully. So before going to execute our package, right click on this, go to on configure, then go to on references, and then here we can add. So I just want to add this by test. Now click on OK. That is fine. Now click on OK. That's it. Now I want to execute our package. So right click on this and click on execute. So here, as we can see, environments, before it was disabled. Now we can check this checkbox and we can see test environment. If we will create multiple environments, then we can see in our drop down. So I want to execute in test environment. That is fine. And in connection manager, we can also replace the connection manager. So this is our server name. So we can replace the server name if we want. In our advanced tab, I want to execute this on 32-bit runtime. That is fine. Now click on OK. I want to see the report. It's still running. So we can refresh and we can check. Now it succeed. Now we can close it and go to on the table and refresh by clicking Ctrl and R. So it is used the values which we have passed in our package. So here we need to specify the values. So I want to specify value 102. That is fine. Click on OK. Then again in Harvard I wish to replace by Roshni. That is fine. Click on OK. Again OK. I want to check the report. Succeed. That is fine. Now we can refresh and we can check we are having 102 and Roshni. So I hope you have understand how we can deploy the package if parameters are available in our package. And then we have discussed about the environment, how we can create the multiple environments and how we can run our package by using that environment. In our next video, we will discuss how we can schedule our package. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Thank you so much.